Welcome back to another video. In this video today, of course, as you can tell from the title, I have some really good stuff to haul, period. And this, you might see me in a different outfit because there's going to be some more stuff I want to include that's coming in the mail in this haul or whatever. So we're gonna go ahead and get started because this video could be kind of lengthy, I'm not gonna lie. I'm gonna be showing y'all, of course, some stuff that I've gotten in the mail, as well as dolls that I have done transformations on. Like, they are good to go to be on the shelf. I just don't put them on the shelf yet until I show y'all because, period, these girls gotta have their cameo, okay? Let's just go ahead and get right into the video. Okay, so consider this also a little bit of a chit chat. As y'all know, I did make a video in regards to addressing some of the things in the doll community that I definitely think need to change for the better. But I actually want to also take the time to highlight the things I really enjoy about the community and why I definitely think if you're thinking about getting back into doll collecting or just doll collecting or toy collecting as an adult, I just want to honestly give you some reasons why I feel like you should definitely go through with that, because I have way more great things to say about the doll community than bad. So I'm gonna just be talking about that as I unwrap and unbox these packages. So the first one that I'm so excited about, I want to give a shout out to Doll Weeb here on YouTube and Instagram for helping me with searching for a jade that was on my wanted list. I really appreciate it. Thank you so much, love. I really appreciate it. So I guess that can be the first thing is, you meet a lot of great people. For one, I have made some amazing friends. Shout out to Derek Edix, Dolly, CC Terrence, and more, TT Toys, BB Dollies, there's so many people. For us all to have a common interest, you know, that some, you know, people in society might deem is weird or psycho, we all think it's normal. I mean, hello, like, this isn't weird to us. It might be weird to them, but we don't care about what they think.
I said what I said. I said what I said. I said what I said.
So I love all of the friends that I have made and the bonds and stuff. And, you know, the other thing I also really like is that most people are very helpful. You know, if you're in search of like dolls, doll items or something, it seems like there's a lot more people that will help you rather than not. I know my friends and I do it all the time, sending each other listings and stuff in the group chat because, period. She's all wrapped nicely. Says the official Bunny Boo, enjoy her. Dolly. Oh, this sticker's so cute. I think I'm gonna keep this sticker. So this jade, y'all, like, I am so grateful, and he gave me such a great deal on her too. I'm so appreciative. Oh my god, she's even better, like, unwrapped. Okay, so this is a styling jade. Sorry, I have my window like wide open. Damn, that's a lot of kids. But anyway, so yeah, this is Styling Jade. She is so pretty. This Jade, like, the face on this Jade is top tier. Like, I honestly, like, oh, she's so pretty. And he did already mention to me that she has a haircut, but I really don't care. I actually kind of like this on her, to be honest, this hair. But if I really wanted to get her rerooted, I definitely could. But hair is just, oh my God, her face is just everything, y'all. Like, she is so, so pretty. Like, her face is just everything. Oh my God. Look at how she ate that. Thank you so much again, Doll Weeb, for helping me get this Jade. Child, I super appreciate it, period. She is so, so gorgeous. My next package that I'll be opening, this package is from Etsy, and I have a little bit of something to say about this girl's. But anyways, more reasons. I feel like joining the doll community has brought out a lot of creativity, and I've seen so many just creatives with like modeling dolls and taking photos, drawings even, outfit designs, creations. Like, you really bring it, like, I feel like it really brings out the artist and a lot of people doll collecting. Especially myself, I learned how to hand sew when quarantine first started, and I was like just hand sewing, like fixing rips in my doll's clothes. I have tried to get better with styling my doll's hair, styling my dolls in general, just all that kind of stuff. Like, it really brings out the artist and stylist in you, and I think that that is so amazing, just to kind of unlock potential you probably didn't even know you had, really. So that's one truly amazing thing. Here is this package. She is all secured. And I got Miss Thang here for a really good price as well. I'll make sure to have it below. So recently, y'all, I remember, especially being younger, the Star Singers were not my favorite Bratz doll, like, at all. My sister had Star Singer Sasha, but I didn't have any, and I didn't care to really have them. But as I have, like, sold a couple off and stuff like that, I kept one, a Sasha, that I actually rebodied, which I will be showing y'all her, period. And the faces on the Star Singers I have grown to be, like, obsessed with. And I didn't realize there was a Star Singers Kiana that actually comes with the Star Singers, like concert, like their own concert stage, but it's a stage where they can, like, twirl around and stuff. I know that the Star Singers are quite sought after in the doll community because people use their bodies and stuff for, like, for DNTMs, for Doll Next Top Model competitions and stuff like that. So, yeah. Okay, so here are her ballet shoes. She put this trash on the floor. And here she is. This is Miss Star Singers Fiona. She is so pretty. I don't know if she has a haircut or not, but she has enough hair for me to deal with, so I'm not complaining. But yeah, I'm so obsessed with Fiona. Fiona has become she kind of always has been, like, one of my favorite Bratz dolls is a Fiona doll. And I just think she's just gorgeous. She's so gorgeous. Her personality is just, like, how could you not love her, period. So yeah, I saw her on Etsy for, like, such a great price, and I was like, oh, child, you know what, let me get her. And I'm not gonna rebody her. I'm actually probably gonna keep her on the Star Singers body for now, just because, you know, I actually like her Star Singers doll as is. Like, her face and on the tall body and everything, I'm in love. So yeah, I got her for such a good price. Yeah, I couldn't pass that up. This huge box. Another reason why I really love the doll community and why I think people should be a part of it is because it's honestly, I feel like, a safe space. Like, it can be very much a safe space. We all go through our own personal things in life as adults, especially with most of us being adult collectors, or even like teenagers or preteens. And I just feel like the dog community is a safe space, and is a safe space for me. It's one of like the happiest things I have going on in my life right now, because I was so happy to get back into it, and then it kind of skyrocketed more when my dog passed away, and I had him for over like for over 13 years. So when I tell you my happiness was snatched from me, it was sadly snatched, but I found love in even more in dog collecting, and I have no desire to stop anytime soon. I talk to people every day about something that really was a big part of my childhood also. I think it's something that also keeps you young, honestly. There's a lot of crazy shit going on in the world, and this is such a great escape for me personally, and I know for a lot of other people. So it's such a safe space, and you can really truly be yourself. You're technically being yourself really through your dolls, but also just being yourself, period. You know, kind of showing the sides of you that you don't want other people to see, or that you feel like someone not might not be so accepting of seeing, if that makes sense. So that's another reason why I feel like the doll community is honestly the shit, period. The box is all covered. So y'all, this box is a lot of dolls that I purchased from Mercari, and I am splitting this up with a few of my friends. But there's like a lot of shit in here, so it's lit. Okay, so this is like all the stuff. Everything's packaged so nice, y'all. Like, gives more of a close-up. I love when they when sellers take the time to do this. Okay, so I'm just gonna like pick out the Ziploc bags. I think I can tell which ones are the dolls. So in this one, no freaking way, bitch. They gave me some stands. Oh my gosh, for real? Oh, child. I am, yes, yes. Are you serious? I didn't even know these were included. Oh my God, yes, we love it. So this bag has a bunch of doll stands. I am here for that, period. Oh my God, what the hell? Okay, and this bag is a, there are a bunch of shoes in here. And of course we're gonna take them out because I want y'all to see at least my favorite shoes in here. But let's see, okay. We have these. These look like these could be like a Designed by Yasmin boots, or like a Girls Really Rock Yasmin boots, just from the gold and like how they look. Bratz Twins Oriana's boots, which I'm excited for these. 2010 like Platinum Shimmers or Winter Dream Chloe. I'm pretty sure it's Platinum Shimmers though, because she has that blue kind of aesthetic going on. These silver heels. Green boots that actually belong to like a fashion pack. These look like Bratz Twins Nevaeh's shoes. These are a Funk and Glow, I think, First Wave Yasmin heels. These are so cute, definitely keeping those. And then these, honestly, if I'm not mistaken, these are probably like Sweet Dreams second edition Yasmin shoe heels. This style of heel is so underrated. Like, it's such a classy style Bratz shoe. It's just so nice, period. But now these boots come also in a fashion pack. I'll try to insert a photo, but this is how they look, but they're like Funk Out Sasha's shoe mold, and they're light blue with this beige. I am obsessed with these boots. And oh my God, I'm so happy to have them. These are also another pair of heels that I've been really wanting. These are just some like chunky Bratz heels that could be for like a Chloe or a Megan or a Jade. So I'm really excited for that. And then these are a pair of Genie Magic Jade shoes. And then let's see, the rest of these are 2010. There's actually a good amount of 2010 heels in here. But the other ones that I'm quite excited about, these are, I want to say Campfire Dana or Phoebe's boots. And they look like they're in really good condition. So, period. Okay, so those are the shoes in this lot. We are moving on. This is Bratz Collector Chloe's, like, corset. This is cute. Here's the first doll. Look at this baddie! Okay, this is Forever Diamond Sasha. She was one of the dolls in this lot. She's so cute. She looks like she's in really good condition. Hair looks like it's never been cut. She's perfect. This is actually going to my bestie, Derek, period. Oh, he gonna love her. All I'm really keeping are her outfit pieces, to be honest, because the dolls in this lot, there were a lot of good shoe and outfit pieces, which is necessary. And it looks like the seller made these really cute ass earrings for her. These earrings are so cute. Oh my God, like, period. But yeah, she's wearing, I believe these are like Collector Yasmin's top and skirt. And then these are Collector Sasha's heels. So yeah, so this was the first doll in the lot, and this is going to my bestie, Derek. Here's the next one. But yeah, so more reasons why I really enjoy the doll community is, there's so many, like, it's like I can't just, you know, pick one. Oh, looking like us reliving our childhood memories, or reliving a part of our childhood we really wish we had, for a lot of us. Because I grew up collecting, loving the absolute fuck out of Bratz. So just reliving this every day is like a dream come true, honestly, like, seriously. And seeing everyone else enjoy it, or seeing everybody, you know, score their dream dolls, or just be able to just collect freely now that they're like older and whatnot. Because one great thing about doll collecting, especially as an adult, is you're in control. Like, no one can tell you what to do, because you most likely are the one who's paying the money to satisfy your unhealthy habit. But yeah, so that's another great thing, is it's like you're reliving this as a child, but you're an adult, and it's like 10 times better, if I should say, because yeah. Okay, this is a Bratz Kids. I'm pretty sure this is a Jade. It's gotta be a Jade. Look how cute she is, and her hair is still in original style. Okay, sorry, y'all. I had to close my window a bit because it just seemed like people kept walking by, like, nosy. Anyway, next doll. Yes, this is the doll I requested. I swapped out one of the dolls in the lot for this one. And this is Miss Mass Blue. Hold on. Midnight Dance. Fiona, she's so pretty. Oh my goodness. She is gorgeous. Now, I know that there have been some people who've had their own opinions about this line, because Yasmin and Fiona are a lot paler than normal, because they're not originally. But honestly, as a kid, when I saw the Midnight Dance line, I honestly thought it was just to go with the Midnight aesthetic, like the dark color, dark makeup with the pale skin contrast. I don't think it was anything like them whitewashing Fiona and Yasmin. I don't think that was the intention at all. If it was, I feel like all of their dolls would be white, you know, but I really feel like it was just to go with the line and the aesthetic. I just thought I would say that, but I love the Midnight Dance line. I think it's so cute, and I loved Yasmin and Fiona the most, so. Here's Fiona. She's in great condition, wearing what looks like more collector outfit, collector clothes. She feels amazing. She looks amazing. I'm so happy to have her, period. And here are her original bottoms, which is great. So I can't wait to see how I'm going to dress this thing up. Period. This is the next doll. Other reasons why, I know I've said I love seeing everyone's creativity just jumping out, you know, on Dollstagram, everyone's photos and stuff like that, and discovering new places where to find dolls, the comfort it brings, the friends and bonds you make with people, just because, you know, society really does make it seem like this is weird, and I mean, it's not, lol. So, but at least we have our own community to, you know, we all understand, like, what the MO is, period. Oh, yes! Okay, so this was another reason why I wanted the lot for this jade. I am 100% sure this is Adventure Girls jade. I'm 100% sure. Oh, my God, her face is so pretty! What? I love this Bratz face. Her head looks a little squished, though, but maybe it's just my eyes are just tripping, but she's so pretty. Now, she's wearing what looks like some Bratz, like hot couture clothes. Damn, she smells really good too. But, so this could be Bratz hot couture Etienne. I'll insert, of course, a picture of what she looks like. And she has Adventure Jade screening, but I felt like her hair, from photos at least, her hair looks like it's like all black, and Adventure Girls Jade has like hints of like, has highlights in her hair, and her hair is Kinecolon. Etienne's hair doesn't look like it's Kinecolon, but correct me if I'm wrong, y'all, in the comments, please do. But I'm 100% sure, because this also is not Etienne's outfit from that collection. But yeah, I'm so sure this is Adventure Girls Jade, and yeah, I'm so happy to have her. This is a doll that I'm definitely keeping for myself. And period. Box. Yeah. Oh, she's really pretty. Oh my God, she's so pretty in person. Sometimes, y'all, Bratz dolls, or just dolls in general, I feel like you ever see a doll and you're really unsure about it, but then when you see it in person, your whole mind just changes about them. So this looks to be, I think this is Funk and Glow Wave 1 Sasha, and she's wearing like a lot of other outfit pieces. Yeah, she's so pretty. I'm gifting this one to a friend as well. And I think that they'll really love her. This is for my friend Dolly, because he loves the Bratz with like the older 2000 screenings. So yeah, but I'm sure this is Funk and Glow Wave 1 Sasha. So that is her. She's actually so gorgeous. Period. Last doll. Oh yes, this is Wildlife Safari Chloe, which I'm also gifting to one of my besties, Edigs. See, I believe she usually naturally has like shorter hair, but this Chloe is really pretty. This is like one of the prettiest Chloes, I feel like, Wildlife Safari Chloe. So yeah, she is gorgeous. I know he's gonna love her. So yeah, those were the dolls in this lot. Let me just grab them all at one time. Here they all are. So cute. The shoes, then the stands, and then of course the bonus Bratz Kids jade. So yeah, that was everything that was in this big ass box or whatever.
Okay y'all, so I know this video seems like it's quite mashed up, but this is me in the future. I just got my other doll box. This should be my pampered pups Yasmin, so I'm going to open her up, and I'm going to open her up and show her. Oh, here she is. Oh my God, y'all, she looks absolutely perfect. Yes, and she's like, so she is pristine in box. This Pampered Pups Yasmin was on my wish list, actually, to have inbox. I think the Pemper Pups line is such a gorgeous line, and it's just so cute with the little dogs and all these accessories. So she will be kept in the box because I'm in love with, like, the heart-shaped style box. And yeah, everything is, like, still secure. And here's the back. Period. Oh, I'm so happy. I'm so happy with this. And this doll cost me, I think, in total, like, $57. So I bought it for, like, $45 before tax, which I thought was a great price, honestly. So I had to snag her. It was, like, the moment was there, and I seized it. Period.
So, yeah. Now, let's see. I'm going to show you guys some other dolls that I have not hauled, but they are all, like, transformed and everything, so I will definitely include what their before conditions were looking like. So let me go ahead and grab them. So y'all, before I do grab the first one, another reason why I want to brag on loving the doll community is how accepting the community is. There's no reason for the community to not be accepting, obviously, but, you know, there are a lot of our LGBTQ plus members that are also doll collectors, and, you know, just a lot of, like, diverse, you know, Black, white, Australian, British, or Italian or Russian or Japanese or Chinese, Black, white, you know, it's very diverse, and it's like a melting pot of the outsiders in modern day America, just all together, blended together. You know, to share not only this common hobby, but even just kind of spread awareness to certain things. I have seen lots of, like, Black Lives Matter doll posts. I've done Black History doll posts. I've now seen Pride doll posts, which I can't wait to do mine. And it's just, like, a place where a lot of people can be accepted as truly who they are. Like, more than be, you know, more than their doll collections, you know, the community is very accepting and seems to be quite open arms. Of course, you do run into those occasional bad apples, but I feel like once you find your friend's group, or just your a friend in general, or someone who can slide up on your story or comments under your photos how much they like this or that or anything, you know, I just see so much, like, love and appreciation for just people being themselves and who they are. I've actually seen a lot recently, people show themselves, because we're all pretty anonymous for the most part. I started out anonymous, so nobody knew what I looked like. And I think it was 2 years ago, I did, like, a face video reveal and shocked anybody who followed me. And then, you know, I just got comfortable, and now I posted myself on my doll account for the first time on the Bratz anniversary day. And yeah, like, and now y'all are seeing me here on your computer or TV screen or phone screen, period. But yeah, so I'm loving seeing, you know, who's the beautiful collector behind the collection, you know, literally real life collector versus collection. We love to see it. So it's wonderful seeing how accepting the community is, and the spread of awareness to even the real life issues that are going on, and who's very aware and wants to show and spread the word in whatever way they can, whether reposting, doing it in doll form, art form, whatever the case may be. So that's wonderful. It was technically a hauled doll, hauled slash recent transformation. This is Birthday Bash Chloe. She is so pretty. So of course she's all cleaned up, hair all, you know, stiff wear. Stiff hair, lol. Her face is absolutely gorgeous. She has on a Fashion Pixies Lena's top, which is from AliExpress. I had, like, gotten a bunch of extras of these. But yeah, I think it fits her so cute though. Like, it just lays on her so nice. Like, I don't know. I just love how this lays on her, like the cut of this and how just it fits on her. She's wearing these jeans, which I really feel like are some Funk and Glow jeans. And then she has on some Funk and Glow purple heels. So that is Miss Birthday Blush Chloe. And this is the one that doesn't have as dark of like eyeliner under her eyes, because I believe there's like two variants of her. But the only thing that's different is like the eye makeup. But yeah, she is so pretty and I'm so glad to have her. So this is Adventure Girls Chloe. I'm so happy to have her. She came with her first full outfit, her pajamas, and then her like lantern and stuff. So yeah, but here she is. I combed out her hair as well. This soft kinecalon hair. And yeah, I put her in her regular outfit because when I got her, she came in her pajamas, but I really, of course, wanted her to wear her outfits. So yeah, this is her. I got her from eBay. Bratz Sweet Dreams second edition Sasha. She is just gorgeous. Like, she's so gorgeous. I have her once in my collection, so this is my second one. The one I have has like cut like hair. Her hair is like thin, real thin. Still gorgeous. Like, I still loved her. I got her in a lot like a couple years ago for $11. So yeah, this one she was I think like 40 on Mercari. But yeah, she doesn't have like any haircuts and her hair is like nice, thick and full. And she also doesn't have any lip chips because mine does have like slight lip chips and stuff. So this one, her face is just so beautiful. This Sasha is so beautiful. Like, I can't get over how beautiful her face is, and I love this screening so much. And she's wearing Treasures Roxy's outfit, as you can see. And then these are some blue heels that she came with. So yeah, she is just everything that I gave her, some hoop earrings. But yeah, so this is her, and she is just giving, serving, all of that. Love her. Well, like 2 days ago, this is 99 Jade. She was the last one I needed to complete the 99 collection because I love the 99 collection so much. So she came with just her robe, heels, and her pajama nightgown. So I'm just gonna make sure I think like at least brush up her hair. But yeah, she is so beautiful. This Jade is so pretty. My friends and I talked about how Jade literally has like no ugly dolls. Like, all her dolls are pretty top tier. I can't really think of an ugly Jade doll on the top of my head. Like, she just, you know, understood the assignment. But yeah, so that is her, and I got her from Mercari. This doll I was really excited about, so I got her from Etsy. Y'all, don't sleep on Etsy. Etsy be having some good stuff for good deals. Now, this doll I had been looking at for over like a month, and I was like, should I get her? Like, And of course, y'all will see what she looked like before. But this is Bratz Play Sports Ice Hockey Yasmin. And I think she was released only in Canada. But that's who this is. Because I didn't know what Yasmin she was. She looked very different. But shout out to Looking Bratz because, period, that database helped. And that's who she is. So her face is so, so pretty. I love her face so much. She has kinecalon hair and it's this really pretty, like, dirty blondish like brown color. It just is so good on her with this makeup. I try to give her these two pigtails with braids, and she's wearing a Play Sports tennis outfit because she didn't come with like any original outfit pieces or anything, but I didn't mind. But yeah, she is so pretty. Like, I love this girl so much, and she was very cheap too. So, you know, I figured this was a pretty cool find, especially also with her being like a Canada exclusive to my knowledge, because she's from the ice hockey collection. So that was pretty cool. Okay, y'all. So I have two more dolls to show that are haul dolls, and then we'll get into the other doll transformations. So let me grab them. Okay, so the last two haul dolls that are also part of the transformations too. So this doll I got from eBay, she was on my wish list. Well, both of these actually. This is a passion for fashion Yasmin. She is so, so pretty. I got her from Mercari. And yeah, she is just so pretty. I'm so glad that I got her. Her hair is dumb long, like 40 inch hair. Yours came in a pack, like literally. So she is so, so pretty. Like this face, I just love her face. I actually am in love with her hair as well. It's very soft after I like conditioned it and everything. It's so soft and I love how long it is. So she came with her original like top. I also think I got her second outfit, like parts of it. And then her heels. All I'm on the search for are her lace like stockings that she wears under this. But yeah, otherwise she is perfect. I think she is so, so pretty and I'm so happy to have her. So yeah, that's this passion for fashion Yasmin. I think between like 2007, 8 or 9, she's one of those. But yeah, she is just beautiful. Another doll that was on my wish list is Miss 2010 Bridget. Y'all, I cannot express how beautiful this doll is in person. Of course, I already wanted her from seeing pictures of her and stuff, but when I got her in person, I was truly, truly blessed with her appearance. Like, she is gorgeous. Like, look at her. Like, I know that's right. Like, she looks so pretty. Now, I just kind of threw on this outfit on her. It was a white skirt and a play sports rock climbing Sasha top. But she's so pretty. Her hair is really soft as well. I love like that it has like some of these like highlights in it as well. And usually I rebody my 2010 dolls. But I can't really think of a body that would just perfectly match her, because she does have a beautiful, unique skin tone. But I don't care, because I actually am not going to rebody her. I think she's just so, so perfect. Like, the way she is. She is just gorgeous, y'all. Miss Bridget. I really want a second one of her. I would love to give her, like, a twin sister or something. But, yeah. So, I am truly obsessed. Okay, y'all. So, now we're going to move on into the other dolls that y'all have seen that have now had their final transformation looks. So let's me grab them. All right, so we are starting off with Miss Feeling Pretty Dana, who you guys did see. So this is the outfit she'll be wearing. She has on this blouse that's super cute and it's kind of see-through with this denim skirt, and then these cute purple mule style heels. Like I said, I really do like this brass shoe mold heel. And yeah, I didn't really have to do much of anything. She came so perfect. If you don't know, I got her in a trade, which I'm so grateful for. So yeah, she is gorgeous and ready to be up on the shelf. I am so excited to put her up on the shelf. Next girl who y'all actually have technically seen, because I had already like redressed her by the time I filmed her in the haul I got her in. But I just want to show her again, Miss Sweetheart Lily. So she will be keeping this outfit on, this blouse, denim skirt, and these heels. If I could find these same heels, but like matching her lip color, that'll be the only thing that I change, to be honest. But otherwise, I think that she rocks this look very, very well. So this is my Sweetheart Lily. Next, this is my Play Sports Tennis Fiona redressed. So here is her final look. It's giving very much vacation and Bora Bora with her NBA basketball player husband, because period. But yeah, this hat is from a fashion pack. This outfit I'm sure belongs to like Spring Break Yasmin's, this like Spring Break Yasmin's outfit. But yeah, I think that this looks really cute on her. And yeah, something about dolls that I redress is sometimes I might like play around and redress them another time, but for now, this is her final outfit look, and she looks so good, period. Next girly that's up that has finally really made her way into my collection, from this bid I won on eBay that y'all have seen. If you have not seen it, definitely check it out. But I already hauled Miss Thang here. This is Funk Out Fiona with that fashion pack on, with this swimsuit, these glasses, and these sandals. And she just looks so pretty. She is such a beautiful doll. Like, I think that she is just so gorgeous, and I love this look for her. Like, this, she's just is honestly everything. So yeah, I'm really happy that she came out looking as she did, which is fabulous nonetheless, period. I just can't think of what I want to put her in right now, but this is what she's been having on, so I figured I'd include her. But this is my Head Games Rena that I got in the same lot with that Fiona, and she's wearing a purple birthday Sasha top, this denim skirt, and then these black, like, thigh-high boots. I really like this for her, but, like, I really would love to have some more extras. Like, I don't know, I'm probably missing like accessories, honestly, because accessories really do set off an outfit for Bratz especially. And it's just a drought right now with trying to get like actual like earrings and stuff. But yeah, so this is her final outfit for now. I think she is ready to go on the shelf though, and should I come across something extra, she will get, you know, added to or whatever. But yeah, here she is, Miss Black Bob Rena. This is my rebodied, restyled star singer Sasha. Her face is so, so beautiful. Like, I'm obsessed. I had this extra Sasha body, so I was like, period. But yeah, here she is. She's gorgeous. She has on this pink top, denim skirt, and then these black chunky heels. Something real cute but simple, and I think that she looks absolutely beautiful. So yeah, that is Miss Star Singer Sasha. I honestly would love for her to be rerooted with like maybe longer hair or something, but so she's definitely perfect. I did get the Rainbow High Twins. I have a review up on, well, not really a review, but I have a video up on my channel kind of sharing my thoughts and stuff on the twins. But I finished redressing one of them, and that's Holly. And it's so funny because in my video I was talking about how Laurel was my favorite twin, but once I redressed Holly, I was like, wait a minute, like, Holly might just be my new favorite. So let me grab her. Miss Holly Cena, here she is. I took her hair down, of course, and I was gonna like flat iron it so I could style it or whatever, but honestly, for what? To like, her curls just fall down so nicely to the side like this. Oh my gosh, I just think she looks so good. She's wearing Skylar's boots, Karma socks. This skirt is from Haunt Couture on Etsy. A Rainbow High top, Karma's jacket, her necklace, her earrings, and of course she's got her neck cocked to the side because, you know, articulation or whatever. But she just looks so good to me. Like, I loved her hair colors the most out of her and her sisters, but yeah, I truly love like this look on her so much, so I figured I would share that with y'all. Miss Holly, cold as ice, period. So yeah, she looks so good. I keep saying the last, this, last, that, but psych. I redressed my mini me again yesterday, I think. But yeah, she's rocking that bag, Holly's bag. She's got like her little phone in her hand, this cute purple and black outfit kind of thing going on. This is Jade's shirt and Crystal's jacket. So yeah, my mini me out here serving looks or whatever, period. But yeah, you guys, so this is a part where I wrap up this video. But yeah, so that's all for today's video, my huge haul, doll transformations. You know, hey, I really like doing these kind of videos, and I hope you guys like that as well. And then I hope you guys enjoy me sharing my own, like, great things about the community and why I think that if you're thinking about joining the dog community or whatnot, definitely join, because it's so great and just so amazing. I've gotten into more dolls as well as I've been in this community. I really thought I was just going to be kind of like pro Bratz, but I'm very open-minded, and I even have like two Barbies that I really, really like in my collection, as well as like Monster High, Rainbow High. I've just expanded my collection a whole lot, which y'all obviously can see that. So that's another great thing, is just kind of like, it's like you experience new things, obviously through dolls, but it's really cool, honestly. You know, thinking that you're going to stick with one and now you're sticking with like 12. But yeah, so that's just amazing. I love watching like doll collectors content as well, people's reviews, and it's really exciting to hear about new doll releases and stuff and things that are coming out. Just because, like, I don't know, this is just something really exciting. Doll collecting is truly an exciting thing, and you know, it holds like something, like some type of value to you yourself, but also to others, because this is something you're sharing with other people that share a common interest / hobby, you know. And it's actually quite interesting when people who aren't doll collectors like see this. It's really cool hearing people like try to understand like your love for this collection, which is great, or like just saying that, though, this is really cool. Like, anyone who's come in my room and seen this, I've had more of like, wow, this is so cool, or wow, you look just like these dolls, or something like that. So that's always like so amazing too. And I think my favorite part mostly about doll collecting, besides the actual hobby itself, is all of the amazing people, my close friends group that I'm in, everyone else, all of the other lovely, amazing, beautiful people that I talk to, and everything. It's just amazing. And yeah, those are just some things I really wanted to put out there. And as I'm even talking about it, I'm appreciating being a part of the dog community even more as I'm talking about it. So I really hope you guys enjoyed this video. Shout out to Doll Weave again. Thank you so much for helping me get Miss Style and Jade. I am forever indebted to this doll, period, and I can't wait to dress her up. She is so perfect and so pretty. But yeah, so I hope you guys enjoyed this video, and I'll see you guys in the next one. Bye, booze.